Hello everyone, my name is Filip Hanzely, and this is UAI 2020 talk on our recently accepted paper with the title 99% of worker-master communication distributed optimization is not needed. So this is a joint work with my two amazing co-authors, Konstantin Mishchenko and Peter Richtarik. So in this work, what we want to do is minimize some average of n functions in d-dimensional space where z is the model over which we optimize. So one can think of it that z is model or parameters of some machine learning models, and fi's or functions fi considered to the data. However, n or the number of those fi's is not really number of data points, but what we consider over here that n is the number of the workers of our distributed system. And first worker then owns function f1, second worker owns function f2, and so on, up to nth worker owns function fn. Those workers can be seen as, for example, some machine or computer in some data center. So those workers are not allowed to communicate among themselves, but rather they communicate to some central authority or central server, and then central server is able to communicate something back to the workers. The class of algorithms we consider is as follows. So the worker computes some sort of local gradient update on the local objective and send it to parameter server. This gradient update can be gradient update of gradient descent or SGD or SAGA SVRG or accelerated SGD or something like that. Then server averages those updates and send them back to the workers. And the issue, which is not present in classical non-distributed setup, is that what is expensive here is the communication between workers and server, and this often becomes a bottleneck of our system. So the most naive way how to, let's say, decrease the communication between server and worker, workers and workers and server, is that what we will do, instead of sending the full vector of coordinates of the gradient, we will instead send only tau fraction of its coordinates. So for example, if tau is 0.1, what we will send is just 10%. And what makes sense on the first view is to choose this tau fraction to be identical across the workers, such that even after the server averages those updates, it will be also sparse, and then the server sends back the sparse vector. However, it turns out that this naive way is hurting the convergence quite significantly, and I mean, the smaller tau is, the slower the convergence is. And consequently, this might not be the ideal way or the ideal approach. Next thing is that it turns out that the bottleneck is not just communication in general, which I will explain now. So it turns out that what workers are sending to the server is, I mean, mutually different vectors. On the other hand, server is sending to all workers identical vector, which is, I mean, the average of whatever workers did send to the server. So again, server is sending to the workers an identical vector or the same vector. So consequently, this often allows for better or faster implementation, and in practice one can see even like 10 times or 20 times faster server to worker communication comparing to worker to server communication. And this really means that the communication on its own is not expensive. What is expensive is just a part of the communication, specifically worker to server communication. This is expensive and this is a bottleneck. So in this paper, we talk about how to reduce this sort of worker-to-server communication. And what we will do some sort of sparsification of the gradient. However, it wouldn't be identical across the all workers, but rather in each worker selects a random tau fraction of the coordinates. And this randomness is done independently across the workers. And what does it mean Now it means that worker-to-server communication is cheap. However, server-to-worker communication is not. However, we already talked about that worker-to-server communication is a bottleneck. This is the first consequence, and the second consequence is that the variance of such gradient estimator that comes from our approach will be smaller than if we did sparsification identical across the workers, and consequently we will have a fast convergence. So let us now look at what our theory is saying, quite informally, but hopefully this will deliver the result. So what we claim is that all workers might do as much as 1 over n level of sparsification independently at random without hurting the convergence. So here, for example, if n, which is number of workers, is 100, then we can sparsify such that we send only 1% of coordinates, or alternatively, we get rid of 99% of worker-to-server communication. What does it mean without hurting the convergence? It means that the new convergence rate will be constant factor at most worse, where this constant is relatively small. So that's okay. Second thing to have in mind, that this thing really doesn't apply just to one specific algorithm, but I mean, we can plug there essentially anything reasonable, for example, like gradient descent, Saga, SGD, or accelerated SGD. We prove it for those algorithms. And there is, however, one catch, and that in general, such sort of strategy is not enough on its own, and one needs to somehow implement so-called Sega trick on top of that if we want to have the fast convergence, where this Sega is like NIPS paper from 2018, and the main idea of Sega was to somehow came up with a way how to run coordinate descent for objectives with non-separable proximal regularizer. Anyway, there is the thing to have in mind is that there is a trick that needs to be implemented on top of that if we want that to work. However, this trick is not needed, for example, if all workers have access to a shared pool of data, or if we are in interpolation regime where the gradients at the optimum are zero, so where we can fit the data perfectly. So in such cases, Sega trick is not needed. But anyway, Sega trick is nothing really to be feared of, so it's something relatively simple. And again, the main idea of the paper, to recap, was that under some assumptions, we were able to reduce bottleneck in distributed optimization, which is communications from worker to server, at no cost for multiple of algorithms using some relatively simple trick, which is independent sparsification. So if you want to see more details about our work, please check out our paper, or please reach out to us. Thanks a lot for your attention.